Next,
we'll use the coil to actually affect the magnet so that we can measure how much of an effect the Earth's magnetic field has. So we'll turn that all the way down, turn it off, and put our compass inside the coil. Now I want to make sure that I know the separation in my coil. So from this edge to this edge is a fine measure of the separation. Because these have some finite thickness, I'll use this edge to this edge or this edge to this edge, not just the inside. I also want to keep track of how many wires I have, how many coils wrapped around. That's stamped on the base. This one has 130. It varies a little bit. Check your own coil. And then I know that the magnetic field of the coil is perpendicular to the face, and I want to deflect the compass and measure how much it deflects for a certain current. So I need to align my coil such that the compass needle is pointing parallel to the face right at zero. So now I know that north, magnetic north, is that direction, and any additional field that I supply is going to tweak the compass needle. So I can turn this back on, drop my range down to 100 milliamps, and as I slowly increase the current, we'll get a deflection of our compass needle. So now the magnetic field of the Earth is pointing this way, the compass is only measuring this part, and the coil is creating magnetic field this direction, and so those two together result to the compass for magnetic field of that direction. I'll want to adjust the current until I get a 60 degree deflection. Letting the compass settle down, and then I would measure that current and then decrease such that I got 50 degrees, measure the current, 30 degrees, 40 degrees, 20 degrees, 10 degrees, all the way down to zero. And then I want to check the other side. Without changing any of my orientation, I'm going to take these out and switch them so that the current is now going in the other direction, and so we should see the compass needle deflect in the other direction, and now we measure a negative current, which is just fine. So I find what current do I need for a 60 degree deflection, measured off negative 28.99, and then what current do I need for a 50 degree deflection, 40 degree deflection, 30 degree deflection, etc., and then zero it back out.